Welcome to Self Principle. As always, I'm Dr. Sean Hashmi. Now, we all know vegetables are great for us, fruits are great for us, and on this channel, I advocate a more of a whole food, plant-based diet. But there's an interesting study out that basically shows that higher intakes of vegetables was not linked to lower risk of heart disease. So what's the deal? Are vegetables good for you or not? Let's find out. So this new study was a study from the Nephrologist Department of Population Health at the University of Oxford, the Chinese University of Hong Kong, and the University of Bristol. And basically, they were looking at about 400,000 participants from the UK Biobank data. And what they were really looking at was how much vegetables they were consuming and whether or not that was linked to cardiovascular disease. So interestingly enough, when they measured vegetable intake, they actually measured it in terms of tablespoons in this study. Now, hold that thought because that's going to become really important. So the average intake of total vegetable intake was about 5 tablespoons. Raw vegetables was about 2.3 tablespoons and cooked vegetables was only about 2.8 tablespoons. They had about a 10-year follow-up going on in this study. And so what were the results? So the initial results was that the risk of dying from heart disease was 15% lower in the highest versus the lowest vegetable intake arm. So far, so good. But here's the problem. When they looked at confounders being, you know, socioeconomic status, smoking, drinking, vitamin mineral supplements, fruit intake, fish intake, red and processed meats, all of those things, they reduced the statistical power of that initial protective benefits of vegetables. So in other words, the likelihood of that initial result actually being real was very, very small. The result's power was reduced by 80%. So most likely these confounders were really what was causing that association to occur. So what the authors concluded was that really vegetables were not likely to be linked to cardiovascular disease. All right, so what gives? Well, let's take a look at that study closer. Remember I said how they measured vegetable intake? They measured it in terms of tablespoons and how the average intake was about 2.5 or 5 tablespoons. Well, what's recommended is 2 to 3 cups per day of vegetables. 2 to 3 cups, average about 2.5 cups, is equivalent to about 40 tablespoons. You heard that right. About 40 tablespoons. So the study participants, they were really consuming about 1/8 to even less than that of the recommended amount of vegetables. So it's not surprising that comparing very, very tiny amount of vegetables to maybe just a teeny tiny bit more of vegetables didn't really show a benefit going on. The other thing that was interesting was that the arm that actually ate more vegetables, they were more likely to already have high cholesterol and hypertension. And as a result, this was a population that you could presume was probably a little bit sicker already. So then the benefit of vegetables might need a little bit more vegetables to actually see the benefit. All right, let's take a step back. What is the bottom line behind this study? Does it change our message to eat more vegetables? And the answer is no. The message continues to be the same. As you shift towards a more plant-predominant lifestyle, you will see more benefits. If you can't go 100%, there is absolutely nothing wrong with that. Just start by adding a few more vegetables to every single meal. That's it. As always, I'm Dr. Sean Hashmi. Thanks so much for checking out this episode. And if you got any topics or questions that you want answers, shoot me an email at selfprinciple@gmail.com, and I'll make sure to address it in a future video. Thank you.